I call this meeting to order, the annual meeting for First Lutheran Church. I think Wendy is ready, our secretary. We were going to begin with a little service, but I do believe we will begin with prayer. So let us pray. Loving God, in holy baptism, you've gathered us together across all human divisions and reconciled us to yourself in one body through the cross. Grant that we who are made new in Christ may live in righteousness and holiness all our days. Strengthen us now by your presence, that our thoughts and actions may be rooted and grounded in your love for us, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Does everybody have an annual report and a budget with them? If not, we can run and get some. We will pretty much go by what the agenda has represented. I think maybe, unless somebody has some questions for Roy Harley about the building, we'll skip that. But other than that, I have, if we could have an approval, a motion to have an approval of the agenda. Who said that? Sorry. Raise your hand, please.
Ken
Johnson. Ken Johnson has made a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Roy Harley has seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
If you've had a chance to look at the minutes from the January 23rd meeting last year, is there any discussion or any problems with those minutes that anybody knows? If not, if we could have a motion to approve those minutes.
Ken
has made a motion to approve the minutes. Do we have a second? Judy Bowes has seconded. All those in favor? Thank you. We will go ahead. I have appointed tellers in case we need to tally any votes. They are Sherry Roberts, Joan Plates, I don't know if John Laidlaw is here, he is, and Nancy Posh. So if there are any tally votes to be taken, they will be our tellers for today. We have ballots for church council. I am not going to send them out because we have five people and we have five people that need to be voted in. Those on the ballot for the five positions are Murph Berg, Judy Bowes, Bob Carlson, Wendy Erickson, and Chuck Stinson. I asked for any nominations from the floor, but you need to have an okay from the person you're nominating. Are there any further nominations? Yes. Kevin Mark has made a motion to cast a unanimous ballot for these people. Is there a second? Sonia has seconded it. All those in favor? So those will be our new council people, besides those that who are continuing on. We ask that they stay for a short meeting following this meeting today. It will not take very long, but we do need to meet with everybody at the end of this meeting. We have Senate Assembly delegates. They are Arlen and Phyllis Johnson. We do need a third one. Is there anybody here that would like to go, or put somebody else's name on? Do you have the dates yet? It's usually the first weekend in May. Right, first Friday, Saturday in May is usually when it is. Well, at this time, those are the people that are on the ballot. If I could have a motion to for a unanimous ballot.
Nancy.
Yes. Nancy has made a motion to accept Arlen and Phyllis to be our Senate Assembly reps. Is there a second? Jill in the back there. All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. We have folks that we have on for a nominating committee for next year. They are Jill Kolsky, Ellen Mackey, Sherry Roberts, Joe Riedrich, and anybody going off the council next year. So, you know, that it's their final term. May I have a, is there anybody else interested in serving on the nominating committee for next year? If I could have a motion to accept these people as the nominating people for next year? Murph Berg has made a motion. Is there a second? Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. We have one further nomination. It is for the Endowment Fund Committee. They meet about four times a year. They had somebody leaving their committee this year. Todd Pedersen has agreed to serve on that committee. If I could have a vote or a nomination for unanimous ballot for him. We had somebody over here. Doris Johnson. Is there a second? Jill? All those in favor? Okay, thank you. We're going to let Brian have a few words before we go on to our treasurer's report and our work on the budget and a vote on that.
Good morning again. I think what I'll do is again try to keep things more brief and really just go over one more time as we met as the GO team this past fall and came up with the five recommendations. I want to make sure before we get into the budget that everyone knows what those are going forward. And those five things are, we would like to hire a volunteer coordinator. We would like to call an intern from the seminary that would start in the fall. We would like to start some, we haven't really have a name for it, we should get a name for it, but a building fund that would look towards the future projects that we have, put aside money every year so that, you know, when we have to replace the roof, we have that money to replace the roof, or at least a big portion of it. So that's number three. Number four, we would like to hire a volunteer coordinator. Did I say that one already? I did? Uh-oh. Well, I'm getting all confused. But I know number four is we want to increase our generosity outside of ourselves by a percentage point. Right now, it is our policy that we give 10% away, no matter what, at the end of the year. We want to make that 11%. And then now I'm all lost. Number five, if it wasn't volunteer coordinator, what? We have three different staff things. And oh, I know. It's actually increasing children's ministry is what it is. We would like to increase the hours that Tina does towards children's ministry to make that a more robust program. So those are the five different recommendations. One note about the parish nurse, we had a good conversation about that 2 weeks ago. And at that meeting, and as we've talked at council, the recommendation has been to continue with the program, but I had a good talk with Adair yesterday, and it's very mutual and friendly. She's acknowledged that she just hasn't had the time she thought she would because of her job in Northfield. And so she is no longer able to do it here. It was a very amicable parting, mutual. She just didn't have the time. So that is still in our budget, and we can of course talk about that, but to look into hiring a parish nurse as well sometime this year. One thing Adair suggested that we don't have to decide at this meeting, it's in the budget, but we might as council, is maybe combining those two. I have a parish nurse / volunteer coordinator. Adair thought that might be a good way to do that. But that is not something we need to decide. Just wanted to throw it out there. So those are the recommendations of the GO team. I feel some urgency to get through our meeting because of the weather, but I do just need to say how blessed we've been in 2012. God has been so good to us in so many ways. It just was amazing. The blessings that seem to just keep pouring in. I mean, the big stuff, like being able to pay off our mortgage and how huge that is, but all these little things too that just kept, some of them just showed up on our doorstep, and then some were very thoughtfully given over the course of some time. And I listed in a couple of newsletters ago, I tried to list as many of them as I could, and it was a paragraph about 2 inches long. So it has been a year of blessings. And I think we are right to give thanks to God for all of his goodness. And even as I've gone through some health problems these last 2 months, just to see the ways that my family has been blessed by this community and this congregation, it is amazing. We have seen the kingdom of God. And so I think we go into 2013 with great hope and optimism. There's no reason as a church we can't be excited about the things to come. So I do want to just say that quickly, and I think I will sit down then. Yeah, that's all I got to say.
Okay, the GO team really did do a lot of work, and of course, like I said a couple weeks ago, it had to do with all the suggestions made by you. It wasn't something they came up with on their own. So I know they maybe deleted some things that maybe were ideas. You know, I don't know everything that went on at that meeting, but on the meetings that you had. But I know they worked hard to get some suggestions that we can work with to go ahead as a ministry at First Lutheran Church here. We will go on to the treasurer's report. Tina, you have a mic up there. She's sitting up in the balcony, and I think she'll probably project some things on the screen. I think this is, I know. So I think, I think this is always the hardest part, probably, of the annual meeting, although I think this year we've come together with a pretty close budget. I'm going to let Tina go ahead, and then if you have any questions, we will try to go around, or if there are any suggestions about change, we'll do it then.
One thing I just want to point out, if you weren't here a couple weeks ago, we did receive some more pledge cards in. So you'll note that there is a difference from your printed report. The deficit budget originally we thought was going to be around $13,000. And if you look up on the screen, the summary shows that right now the budget's at a $6,500 deficit. And that's pretty good compared to the last few years, I think. And I'm not really sure what other detail you want me to go in, so I guess I'll just answer any questions maybe.
Pastor Brian, you have the mic. Are there any questions about the? I mean, you've had a chance probably to look over, the detailed part of it, the staffing, and the where the money is coming from that's sitting in each of the ministry team budgets. I think all is pretty fair. But are there any questions or comments? Just raise your hand and we'll bring a mic to you. Okay. I think if somebody would like to make a motion to approve the budget or deny it, I guess whichever you feel you would like to do, but we can go ahead. Dennis Johnson has made a motion to approve the budget for the 2013 year. Is there a second? Sherry Roberts has made a second. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The budget is approved. I don't think, unless somebody else has some further comments, I know Pastor Brian last year asked for all the good things that have happened. I think he did mention some of them. I think we've been very blessed this year with people that have come forward to take care of things when Pastor Brian's been sick, just to take care of everything around the church. I'm very thankful for everybody here who's willing to step forward and do their part whenever they are asked. I know when it comes to getting council people and to do those extra things, it is kind of hard, and everybody is busy. So we do thank you for that. If there is no further business, we will consider this meeting adjourned, but we will please close in prayer. Heavenly Father, remember our congregation, your people here today. We thank you for your comfort, for help in all areas of our lives, for courage and strength to face challenges, and for your guidance as we go ahead with plans to be your servants here in Red Wing and wherever we may be asked to serve. Continue to bless us with your grace and mercy. Give us the faith, hope, love, and joy that we need to live our everyday lives for you. And we go now to share our love for you with others through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you. And if we could meet with the council people, probably right down the front here would be great.